Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is Barbell, and welcome back to some more Skyrim action. Long time no see, right? A lot of things been going on, but here we are. We are back in the magical land of Skyrim and Snowberries. Ooh, Snowberry. And I am happy to be here. So let's go ahead and open up the old to-do list for this episode. A couple of things I have listed here were actually in the comment section of the last episode. So thank you guys for pointing these things out. The first thing I have listed is I need to return to High Point Tower to get the mage robes that I missed. For those of you who did not watch the last episode, I found the source of the Ashspawn attacks on Neeloth, and it was his old apprentice. So we styled on that fool, and I got distracted by my Draugr Deathlord, who had this big-ass Scythe of Death. So I figured I had the Grim Reaper on my side, and that was just so distracting, I forgot to actually loot the body of the old apprentice. What was I thinking? I am so stupid! So I'll go ahead and go back to High Point Tower, pick those up. Apparently they are unique, so I'm kind of curious to see what those are all about. And then after that, I'll just go into some water, you know, go for a little swim, a little swimmy swim, to test Neeloth's spell. He put a spell on me, and he said to watch out for side effects, but it didn't give any more information on that. And I was kind of clueless on what would activate the side effects, and a bunch of people said, just go into some water. I'm like, okay, that's what I'm going to do. And, after those two things are accomplished, because they shouldn't take very long, it is time to face off against the bitch-ass Mirak. I am so excited. I got so many things. I'm so prepared for this fool. Oh, it's going to be so good. Let me close the journal here and show you what I'm talking about. First of all, I have the Greater Power Summon Karstag. That is the Frost Giant boss that was completely owned. I don't even remember what episode it was, but I think it's titled Karstag, so it should be pretty easy to find. That was quite the fight. He was a boss. I'll give him that. He was a true boss. And he, like, came out in a huge ice explosion like, what's up, brah? He sent me flying. Oh, it was crazy. You've got to check it out. It was pretty damn cool. But, yeah, it allows me to summon Karstag to fight for me for 120 seconds outside only. And it may only be used 3 times before it disappears forever. That's kind of lame. Apparently, there are mods that allow you to use it infinitely. Still a greater power, but it won't disappear after 3 times. I don't know if I'll download that or not. One other thing I picked up off camera is I picked up the Draugr Death Overlord spell. Now that's a spell I have been hyping since part one of this Let's Play, damn it. Okay, so I'm pretty excited to get this, finally. It is a master level spell. It summons a permanent Draugr Death Overlord armed with an ebony two-handed sword and bow wherever the caster is pointing. So it is just like a Flame Thrall, where it's a permanent summon. There we go. Thrall. Summons a Flame Atronach permanently. Look at that cost! Sweet Jeebus! Look at the magic it cost! The reason why it's so high is I do not have the Master Level Conjuration perk yet. So I got those things. There's another thing I have. It is the Secret of Arcana. That is one of the Black Book rewards that I chose. And it allows spells to cost no magicka for 30 seconds. So that will definitely come in handy while facing off against Mirak, the King of Lames. We also got Mora's Booty! Fully restores your health, magicka, and stamina. Hell yeah! I mean, I got all this shit. Look at that. Dragon Skin absorbed 50% of the magicka for hostile spells for 60 seconds. Who knew I had that? Even though I've received billions of comments saying, dude, why aren't you using your Dragon Skin power? I'm like, I don't know. I'm just stubborn, that's why. So, we got a huge arsenal of stuff we can use against Mirak here. And I also picked up the final Dragon Soul required to unlock the Fool Shout, so let's do that. Boom! Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Thank you, game. Thank you for telling me which Black Book to read. I was actually slightly concerned about that, because look at all these Black Books we have. So there's plenty to choose from. I remember I tried to find Apocrypha another time, and I went through every book, and it turns out the last one I chose was the correct one. So I was like, that figures. Who's this? Who's that over there? Just sitting on the bench, kind of creeping, watching the Archmage over here. Look how creepy that is. I'm just over here minding my own business, talking to you guys, lovely viewers. And he's sitting over there with his legs spread. See underneath his robes? That's wrong, man. Dude. You're wrong. And look at that, he's getting drunk too while he's watching me. Oh god, that's creepy. Get me out of here. Get me out of here. So we need to go back to... need to go back to Solstheim. See what's going on. I need all the Dragon Priest masks for this. Oh my god, there's so much left to do in this game. It is redonkulous. Redonkulous. Oh my fuck! I hate you guys. I seriously hate you guys. Let's see. What do I want to do? Oh, first of all, I want to reconfigure my spells here. Okay, I'll keep Drug or Deathlord for now. Incinerate, good. Actually, well, hold up a minute. Let's mix things up a little bit. We'll do Fireball. What's Incinerate? Get that out of here. Fireball is the area of effect adept spell. Watch and learn. Boom! Awesome. And then we got Icy Spear, which is the expert spell for ice. It's just like Ice Spike, but larger and more powerful. Who'd have thought that? And then I'll keep Lightning Storm because it is so badass. Check this out, guys. Ugh! I bet I could blow this wall up if I stood here long enough and kept shooting lightning at it. But I don't think the people of Raven Rock would appreciate that. Also, one other thing. Gameplay, yeah, it's on Master. I was testing out a few things with another character I'm doing. I'm not really spending much time with it, just using it to test things out. So there we go, we got it on Master. Or not, damn it, it was on Master, now it's on Legendary. Legend, wait for it, Dairy. So what am I doing? High Point Tower, let's go. Oh god, Charis, I hate these dudes. They are so annoying. They poison you, just like their farmer bros. And for some reason, they can be surprisingly difficult to kill. Hi, Firefly. What's up, Archmage? Holy shit, did that thing just talk? Whoa. Am I, like, going in the opposite way? Was there an exit door I could have gone in to make this a lot easier? Probably. Dang, dag, nabbit, fellas. But we are here in High Point Tower. Let's just kind of... Oh, wait, here we go. This is the exit, right? Yeah, here it is. All right. Much, much better than what I was expecting. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Well, I guess while I do this stuff, since there probably won't be any combat. Probably. I have a question of the day for you guys already. And I believe I asked this or some sort of variation of this question in the past. But, where's the corpse? Oh, no, you didn't. You did not just decompose on me. There's no dirt in here. You should still be here. You should be rotting. Oh, no. Fuck. Let me look around a little more. Maybe her bed? Maybe her corpse has moved. How did I confuse corpse for bed? I don't know. Let me make sure she's not up here before I jump down. All right, but the question of the day... if you could live, let's say you're living in Skyrim, right? And you could choose any city to live in, which one would you choose? I was going to show you the world map, but got this dumbass Solstheim map right now. Okay, so we got Whiterun, and it doesn't have to be in the city. It could be the Hold, but I haven't memorized all the Hold names yet. There's like Hafengar, the Pale. I think there's Whiterun Hold. That one's kind of easy. There's the Rift. That one's kind of easy for Riften. Holy shit. Hey, Skeleton, give me your gold. Yeah, so which city or hold would you live in? For me, I would have to choose Falkreath. I don't know if it's Falkreath hold or not. I think it is. Alright, and the corpse doesn't appear to be here. But Falkreath is so... I don't know, it's like peaceful? It does have Spriggans though, and I hate Spriggans. I hate Spriggans because when you take them down to low enough health, they just like kneel down and then they super heal and they're like, what's up, bitch? I'm back. And I'm like, oh, damn it. Gotta spend Mo Magicka to kill your ass. Ornate Maul. It is very ornate. And I have the carry capacity. And don't worry, I did not forget the question of the day contest from the last episode. I will be doing that momentarily. Okay, well, I guess her corpse disappeared and just said, fuck you, to the Archmage of Ultimate Power. She was like, well, if you don't take my robes while I'm here the first time, you ain't gonna get them ever. Oh. Well, you guys are more than welcome to leave a comment down below describing what the unique robes did. Wait, is she in one of these baskets? Come out! Get out of there! No? Are you in this one? Get out! Ugh. That sounds stupid, but you never know with Skyrim. And look at those lovely mantle decorations. Decorations. English. English, motherfucker! Do you speak it? Apparently, I don't. Alright. Well, that sucks. I don't know, part of me is saying go back and look again, but I've already spent quite a while looking in there. That, oh, damn it. And if the corpse was actually there and I just walked right over it, feel free to also leave a comment saying, "Hey dude, you are totally blind. The corpse is right about here." And then list the location of where it's at, and I'll come back in the next episode and pick it up. Hopefully. Alright, so we got that out of the way, I suppose. The next thing was to walk in Wowda. I guess we'll just do it by Telemithrin. Why not? Neeloth is there. It just makes sense. So yeah, just a brief recap. Which city or hold would you guys choose to live in if you could? Falkreath, like I said, it's peaceful. It seems... Whoa, excuse me. It seems warmer than the rest of Skyrim because it's the southernmost portion. Or it's in the south. And I don't know. It's just a very nice looking place. Hey, Dusty! What's up, bro? What in the piss is going on back there? I see magic, so we have to intervene. I think I dipped my toe in that water. You know, god damn it. Alright, get wet. I'm getting wet. I'm so wet. Look at how wet I am. I'm just getting my sneakers. My sneakers are getting wet. Let's go out here a little bit. Alright, I'm totally dunked. I am submerged. I'm having a grand old time. There we go. So what's the side effect? I didn't see a side effect. Alright, let's armor up before we style on these fools with lightning storm. They will have no idea what hit them. Kamehameha of ultimate badassery. Time to charge him up. Yeah, sit right there. No, no, no. Stop. Stop firing spells. Stop it. Oh, fuck. Now they're going to make me move. All right. Nobody makes the Archmage move. I hate cardio. Oh, you don't like that, do you? All right, fool. Where's the other one? All right. You get some ice action. Ow. Let's ice this guy. It's time to kick some ice. All right, my ice-related puns are over. I am not a Mr. Freeze. Would you stop that bullshit? Oh my god, okay. I'm getting up in your grill space and we're ending this right now. I don't care if you're a fire wizard. You're fired. Okay, I couldn't resist that one, all right? I won't stop. Can't stop, won't stop. Fuck you, fuck your corpse, get out of here. I'm pretty sure I vaporized her corpse. I'm sorry. I blacked out for a moment. Pure rage took over because she kept dodging my icy spears. Nobody does that and survives to tell the tale. All right, so we got a side effect. Is it like listed in active effects? Damage health, Neeloth's health boost. Health is permanently lowered 25 points after swimming or being in the rain. Oh, so if I was busy singing in the rain, I would lose health. Huh. And I like how it's a health boost. What kind of boost is that? A boost of the bullshit meter, maybe. A huge boost. 25 points to be exact. What's this? Clam. Hey, Clam. He's really clamming up about the situation. Ha ha! I feel like I made that joke before, and therefore it is twice as unfunny. I apologize. What's going on today? Things are especially wonky. Like, the wonky levels are super high. They're too damn high. Am I supposed to like... Alright, I'll just talk to Neeloth. We're here. But soon. Mirak, he has no idea the storm that is coming his way. I got Karstag, I got Draugr Death Overlord, I got infinite magicka for 30 seconds. I got full magicka replenishment power. Oh my god. He will know what to do. He'll be like, help! I don't know what to do. And then I will proceed to blast him with spells. Alright, Neeloth, where you at? Your dumbass spell took away some health. What are you doing, man? You are weird. Oh, that he's complimenting my robes again. He's like looking at me up and down while I'm turned around. He's like, Alright, hey Neeloth.
The ash from Red Mountain holds secrets. Secrets I mean to uncover.
Well, feel free to go over there. Excuse me, do you not see me talking to Neeloth? Get out of here, kid. Your spell made me weaker once I got wet.
Wet, you say?
Yes.
I suppose, yes, I can see how that would have inverted the tether.
That's stupid. You're stupid.
Couldn't you simply avoid water?
No.
No, no, that won't do. Can't have you forego bathing. The Ashlands can leave one a bit...
Bathing? And it's, was I supposed to be bathing this whole time?
Here,
oh.
I'll just remove it.
Well, I guess that's why I'm kind of stinky.
Should help mitigate your inconvenience.
Yeah, thanks. Is there like any other missions I can get? How's Drovas? What do you have for sale? What does it mean to be a member of your house? I think I asked that already.
I wonder if a dragon could be captured alive.
Shut up.
It would make a fascinating test subject.
Shut up. We'll capture a dragon later on at Whiterun if I ever get back to the main story. Sweet Jeebus. I didn't see anything else in his dialogue options. Do you have anything to talk about?
I don't know how he does.
Oh my god, what is up with my camera? Sweet Jeebus. Oh, you can be a follower now? Well, I'd rather not have a guy following me around complimenting my robes every 5 seconds. Alright, so we took care of that. No big deal. Alright, I guess it's time to go face Mirak. See what's going on. I don't know, do I have any additional spells or effects? No. Alright. Alright, I don't know what else to say. So, waking dreams, I believe? I'm coming for you, Mirak. Oh, excuse me. Mirak. Oh, Mirak. Holy shit, a dragon. Don't make me no difference. We're gonna bend some will up in here. Am I armored? I am armored. Good, just in case. Where are you? What the fuck? What was that? Not a good first impression, dragon. Seriously. Sardotar. Use it, please. It's a bit chilly in here. Would you mind? Stop freezing me, you jerk. I bended the will. I bended all the will. Thank you. Good God. That would have been a very bad way to start off this episode. And you look kind of wonky. Look at them eyes. Look at them derp eyes. Let's get a good angle here. There we go, look at them derp. Look at them derp eyes. Oh, he's derping. Alright, Sarutar. What the piss? Alright. I'll just kind of clip through your neck here. Whee! When riding a dragon, you can lock onto a nearby target and attack it with magic. You can also command the dragon to attack your target. Fast travel while riding the dragon by using your world map. For more detailed information, see the help section of the main menu. Since we're inside the book, I wonder if this counts as outside. Alright, hang on. First of all, I have one other thing I need to turn on. Oops, sorry, I had to scratch my head. Display? General subtitles. There we go. So you guys can read what the dragon's saying. Look at that! What is up with that square? Hermias Mora, explain this square nonsense. What's going on here? Alright, is that just gonna go unaddressed? Alright, okay. Wait, what spells do I even have equipped? I don't know what I have equipped. Is there a way to lock on to targets? Oh shit, that's a journal. God damn. Oh shit, everything's going wrong here. This is. Am I locked on? Does it like auto lock? Shit. This is so. Oh, thanks for telling me now. Damn. Alright, lurker. This is. Oh, jeez. I remember a lot of people were disappointed by dragon riding. Like, it was listed in the DLC. I guess trailers or whatnot before it came out. Like, you can ride dragons and obliterate shit. And everyone was like, whoa, finally. My dreams have been realized. And then it turns out to be this. And everyone's like, oh, man. Well, it's good I have Fireball equipped because it's an area of effect. That allows me. Well, dude! Don't scare me like that. Do not submerge me in the sewage water, please. I can be hurt. Can I heal myself, please? I'm equipping my heal spells, but they ain't doing shit. Well, that's no good. Got him. Seriously, no one's gonna address that mysterious, like, square void? Hermias Mora, he's like hiding somewhere. He's so ashamed of this weird square void in his realm. He doesn't even know how it happened. These look like giant cacti. Am I alone on that? Use E to land. All right, land. Land him up.
We'll look for a spot to land.
This looks like a badass spot to land. Oh shit, guys, it's happening.
No, not yet. We should greet our guest first.
Right, get off. I am here. Power up.
Dragonborn at the summit.
Oh hell yeah.
No doubt, just as Hermaeus Mora intended. He is a
you stepping to me?
Master, you know.
I'll step right back.
But now I will be free of him. My time in Apocrypha.
Wait, let me get up here. There we go.
You are here in your full power, and thus subject to
full
my full
power.
You will die, and with the power of your soul, I will return to Solstheim and be master of my own fate once again.
Like hell you will. Are you for real? Is this dude for real right now? Did he just hit me with shock? Or, sparks? Excuse me. And firebolt? Oh no, Mirak. You are in for it, buddy. You are so in for it. Use it, please. Oh, this has to count as inside. Damn it, fellas. Well, good thing I bought the backup plan. This is the entire reason why I bought the Draugr Death Overlord. Actually, let me go over here and see if, like, I need to be in a different spot. Damn, that was gonna be so cool. Oh, well. All right, bitch. Wait, did I conjure a Death Lord on accident? Oh, where'd he go? Get over here. I've been hyping this battle for such a long time, and I'm kind of disappointed he's not using more powerful spells. Maybe he gets tougher, like, the lower his health gets. Look, I hit almost half health already. What a clown. Oh, wait, I got another thing I should use. He thinks he's so cool with his dragon armor? Well, back up, bitch! I got that shit, too. Heal him up! Are you shitting on my Draugr? That is unbelievably rude. Where'd he go? Wait, now, let me make sure. Is this a Draugr Death Overlord? It should tell me in the... that's a Draugr Death Lord. Let's bring out the big guns. Oh, yes. Here, I'll put it in both hands just to make sure I don't flub it up again. All right, let's just drink Magicka Potion so I can cast it. Ultimate, why not? There we go. Hit him! Oh, yes! I know it didn't affect him, but you guys heard that full-powered, unrelenting Forge shout. Oh, it's gonna be so good. Oh, he fully healed? How'd he do that? What a loser. And holy shit, he's, like, warping around everywhere. Don't make me no difference. Oh, shit! I should use some shouts, too. Do I have any full-powered shouts? Whoa, Soul Tear. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, that counts as a conjuration, though. I'll just leave my Death Ward out for now. Are you stepping? He's stepping. Ugh. He's shouting Cyclones at me. Oh, this is so wonky. Draugr's about to return the favor, bitch. Where'd he go? Oh, he's... Good God. Quit trying to escape your fate, Mirak. It ain't gonna happen. I'm pretty sure he's already realized that he's gonna lose this. It's like guaranteed. And I don't want to use my Secret of Arcana skill if he's just gonna fully heal again. Oh, nope! Screw your tornado bullshit. Actually, I'll return the favor. I will return the favor, good sir. Where'd he go? Oh! Oh my god! Draugr pip smacked that dragon. He's like, you gonna do anything, Mirak? No? Alright, well, I'll take care of this dragon. Well, oh shit, sorry, dude. Oh, I'm so sorry. I meant to hit Mirak, but apparently he's vulnerable to shouts. I should have just kept casting. Yeah, look at that full power over Lightning Force Circle. Oh shit, up. Oh, that kind of hurt. Oh well, healed up. Don't matter now. Oh shit! God damn it! Stop that! That's so lame! Because you're making me cast this over and over again. Ugh. Screw your ward. I bet this blows right through it. Where'd he go? Ugh. Yeah, you better gah. What are you doing? Ugh, not again. You piece of shit! You better accept what's coming to you. Wait a minute. No! What'd he do? Oh, shit. Oh, does he absorb the dragon? No, not the wonky dragon. Damn it, man. That's, oh, you're gonna get it now. That was my only mode of transportation up here. And you took that from me. Oh, shit. Stupid tornado bullshit. All right, I think he absorbed the last dragon, right? Let me look around. Oh, God. Stop pooping on me, man. Who does that? That's so rude. Let me just take the time to loot this dragon mid-boss fight. Yeah, no problem. I don't think I'll be back here, so I just want to make sure I get this over with. Alright, since that's the last dragon, let's go ahead and Secret of Arcana it up. And now you die, good sir. Oh, my Draugr finally died. Draugr finally bit the dust. Oh, wait, does that mean I can use Dunavia? Where you at, buddy? It's in conjuration, right? Summon Dunavir. Oh, it's a shout. Herp derp. Does it not work here? Where is he? Did he not actually summon because it's counted as inside? Oh, man. All my plans are being ruined. Oh, well, we'll do this. We'll do this the hard way, one-on-one. Is this punk really using a staff right now? You got nowhere to hide, dude. There's no more dragons to absorb. You are out of options. Where do you go? Why are these tentacles spying on me? Where are you? Where'd he go?
Get to
Oh. Oh, shit.
To escape me, Mirak.
It's Mirak.
You can hide nothing from me here.
The tentacle's like not really going through him.
No matter. The new dragon board.
Let me kill him. Harass Mora. Damn. Oh my God. Is he like Hocket Loogies now? Ugh.
May
this place is nasty.
Be rewarded for his service as I am.
Mira. Harbor fantasies of rebellion against me.
Oh my God. That is oddly brutal.
Serve me faithfully, and you will continue to be richly rewarded.
You're called as richly rewarded? I don't know, man. I feel like I'm getting the sucky end of this deal. Alright, this time I won't forget to loot the boss's corpse for crying out loud. Mirak! Increases your magicka by 50 points. That is kind of weak. Is it just me, or is that kind of a weak reward? For a boss? Like the big hyped up boss for the Dragonborn DLC? And you get a magicka increase by 50 points? Whatever, yoink. Mirak's boots adds 5% to the dragon breath and spell absorption of Mirak's robes. Okay, Mirak's gloves adds 5% to the dragon breath and spell absorption of Mirak's robes, alright. Mirak's robes absorb 15% of the magicka from dragon breath and spells. Chance on hit to spawn a tentacle explosion. What the fuck? Value of 100? I don't know what's going on. I seriously don't know what's going on anymore. Mirak's staff. Sprays writhing tentacles on the ground that stagger and poison foes that enter them. Therefore, poops on enemies. Mirak's sword. Absorb 15 points of stamina. That's kind of random. He was a mage, right? So why is he absorbing... I don't freaking know. Mirak, you are weird, dude. I got a good place for you. Come with me. Come with me. Stop being stubborn. Even in death, he's being stubborn. And why is the sword still there, even though I took it? I did take it, right? I did. Wait, can I take this sword, too? All right, kind of random. All right, come with me. Come on. All right, here we go. You and me having our last conversation together. How do you feel? Not talking, eh? Alright, I see you're a little humiliated in your defeat. But you get to go for a swim. Here you go. See you later, fuckers! Shit! It was just absorbed by Apocrypha. The ultimate see you later, fuckers. Alright, let's see what's the reward for this one. Oh, man. Was the explosion necessary? I don't think so. Wait, what the hell? What is this? What's going on here? Clear sneak perks. Clear lockpicking perks. Clear pickpocket perks. So, okay, so it clears the perks and any of the skill trees that you want. Although, doesn't creating a skill as legendary do the same thing? Huh. I guess you use this if you get a skill, or you have a skill that has perks, but you don't want to get it all the way to legendary, you just want the perks back. Say, screw this. I don't want to do this no mo. I see. Well, do I have any skills that have perks invested that I don't want? I doubt it, because why would I put a perk into a skill I don't want to have perks in? I don't know. This is a little wonky. Kind of cool, though. But as I said, a little redundant since, you can just make a skill legendary. And I have a perk point, apparently. I think I had it in the last episode, too, and I just didn't decide what to spend it on. Let's investigate this real quick. Okay, I need level 60 to get level 2 recovery. Some people have asked me to get level 2 of recovery, but I can't because I'm not level 60 of restoration yet. Alright, well, that's kind of cool. Kind of cool here. Pretty neat. Pretty interesting. Let's go back to Solstheim, and that was the boss battle with Mirak. Like I said, I hyped this damn thing up since the start of the Dragonborn DLC episodes, which has been quite a while now, and it's over. I'm kind of clueless as to what to do with myself now. That was the big finale, even though I do have some stuff I can do here on Solstheim still. What is going... Oh. I got this ultimate power aura going on around me. Alright, so what do I do now? I mean, I've got a few quests here. I can get Taproots, whoopee. I can speak to Adrilla Arano, I think the second counselor of Ravenrock, to investigate the attempted murder on the counselor, I think, or something like that. Oh my sweet Jeebus, diplomatic immunity. Main story quest, meet Delphine and Riverwood. That just shows how little of the main story I've done. Oh boy, oh boy. Let's see, what other things do I have? Pale Lady. Oh yeah. I believe I came across Frostmere Crypt while I was on my way to one of the first dungeons of Dawnguard. That was quite a while ago. That's a Daedra quest. Oh, yeah! Yeah, I mentioned after Dragonborn DLC I'd go back to completing the rest of the Daedra quests. Holy sweet Jeebus, it's been so long since that point! Wow! Okay, I guess I'll go back in here to Neeloth and see if he does have a side quest for me. Because I want to get the Whirlwind Cloak spell. That's the entire point of me doing his damn side quests. It's going to be so cool. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed that boss battle. I mean, it wasn't quite as difficult as I expected. And I know it was on Legendary because I made sure to do that before I left Ravenrock. Wow.
Hold still. Let me get a good look at you.
Okay, you're not turning into your apprentice, are you? Admiring my robes from afar? What are you looking
Incipient
for?
Incipient madness, loss of self-awareness, black spots in the white...
Oh, I'm self-aware of my ultimate power. You better
Any
believe
of the
it.
Documented indications of Hermaeus Mora's permanent influence.
Fuck Hermamora! He ain't shit! Oh, why are you so worried about that fool?
When I first saw you.
You don't need to worry about me. Hell yeah.
I wasn't worried, just interested. I don't get to observe firsthand many people who have spoken to Hermaeus Mora.
Well, trust me, it's not an interesting conversation. He speaks very slowly. It's like the Ents, the tree Ents from Lord of the Rings.
Who?
Saying things in old Entish takes a long time to say.
Hermaeus Mora turned on him when you looked like the winning bet. Or a bit of
bet. Of course I'm the winning bet.
Has vanished from
you don't even need to bet, because it's guaranteed I'll win. So that's a pointless bet for anyone who would go against me.
Why? Did something interesting happen?
Or should I say it's just a pointless bet altogether? No, nothing interesting. I just styled on Mirak and saved Solstheim and the rest of the world because I'm a total badass baller motherfucker of ultimate power.
Well, that is what you hero types do, isn't it? I wasn't expecting anything less.
That is
now,
true.
All that's left are these black books. It's a shame I haven't located any more. So much more to be learned.
Yes. I wonder, do I have all the black books? I am unsure of this. Let's see, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I have 7 books. Feel free to leave a comment down below if there's any more I need to collect. That would be pretty cool. Anyway, Neeloth.
My new steward is acceptable.
Ah, here we go. Help with research.
Can you? Of course you can. What took you so long to ask?
What?
I've been trying to adapt Redguard magic to the Ash.
Okay.
I think the key concept I'm missing is...
Aha! I think this is the quest!
Asariat's book.
You have to look for a book, and I think this is it. Hell yeah!
I have some associates and correspondents who find things for me.
Oh, really?
There's a credible rumor on where this book might be. And all right. I'd like you to find the truth of the matter.
Alright, let's do that. Let's do that shit.
Don't just stand there. Go get my book.
What an impatient fool! I just ended the dialogue. And he's like, don't just stand there. Hop a derp a derp. Man, I will blast you with lightning storm. Oh, and that reminds me. When he blasted me with that spell, and I thought it was a calm spell, and I was freaking out about it, I think that was the spell that was responsible for looking for that side effects quest. I guess I didn't put two and two together there. I was just like so taken aback by him randomly blasting me with that green spell. I was like, holy shit, did he just do that? I even powered up and everything. I was ready to throw down. I was so ready. Alright, I'm just kind of wandering around aimlessly here. Gloomreach. Sounds like a rather gloomy place. Oh, we gotta go back to Skyrim? Alright. Alright, back to Skyrim. Here we go! Oh, these assholes are gonna be right up in my face again. You know it. You just know it. Here we go. Incoming! Incoming!
If you're looking for passage,
I don't believe. Oh, there we go. Yep. Yeah. Okay.
Oh, God. If you're looking for passage,
move! You're. Oh. Well, this guy's looking rather dashing. I like how this guy tells me I have fancy robes. Look at that shit. He's got that pirate hat and everything. Captain Jack Sparrow. What? I didn't know he was in this game. Alright, Gloomreach. Of course it had to be in the middle of nowhere, where there is nothing nearby that has been already discovered. Alright, guess we'll go to Rorikstead. Rorikstead. I'm from Rorikstead. Oh, really? Alright, let's do this. Kinda random. It took me quite a while to find the final dragon for the Benwell shout. I did that off camera. Alright, get a little closer. Oh yeah, you don't like that. I don't care. Look at that. I don't have to aim with this. I just have to follow him. He's so pissed! Yeah, you better believe he's landing now. He's like, oh damn it, I can't do that totally dick move where I just fly around in circles and make him try to hit me with projectile spells. Guess I'll have to go down there and fight. Yeah, that's right. Oh, don't land on my head, jerk. In the booty! Whoa, he's like floating around and shit. Oh, he's screwed. He's so screwed. It's over. He can't fly away. I can do this all day, pal. Yep, in the booty. Constant stream of lightning to the dragon booty. Can't feel good. And it's roasting over an open fire. What a fitting fate. Dragon booty on an open fire.
How did you come to possess such a rare thing?
Are you looking in my back pocket checking out my rare possessions? How dare you do that, sir? At least buy me dinner first. Alright, Flawless Garnet. Gold. Alright.
Another quiet day.
What the fuck? Another quiet day. Meanwhile, dragon in the middle of town. Dragonborn comes in, absorb its soul. Yeah, The usual for Skyrim. Alright, what are we doing? Oh yeah, Glimreach. And I'm going in complete opposite direction of where I need to go. That guard's comet. It's like Javis, man. Alright, Glimreach. Well, I guess while we walk around the vast open plains here. I recently saw The Amazing Spider-Man 2. And, it was... I don't want to say it was a good movie, but it entertained me for the length that it played. You know? Like, I didn't leave the theater thinking, wow, that movie was excellent. And it really made me think, and it brought up some good points. I mean, the action was pretty good. What am I, turning into a movie reviewer or a movie critic? Anyway, the action was good. I'm not a huge fan of Jamie Foxx, but I feel like his portrayal of Electro was pretty damn good. I'm going to walk face first into this dumbass Forsworn camp. And the music, okay, the soundtrack was pretty damn cool. You guys know that I'm a fan of movie scores because of the question of the day from a few episodes ago where I asked what kind of music you guys listen to. I mentioned that movie scores were probably my favorite genre. Oh my lord. Alright, we'll just have to do this the wonky way. I got the anti-ass-kicking shield for a reason. But yeah, the soundtrack was awesome. Is that a saber cat down there? Oh, it's a bear. Bernstein Bear is going to try and claw my face off. No, thank you. Yeah. I mean, it's pretty good. So I'm kind of curious what kind of thoughts you guys have on that movie. And I guess a proper question of the day is, which Spider-Man movies do you prefer? The Amazing Spider-Man series or the Tobey Maguire Spider-Man series, that trilogy? I guess if I had to answer that, I think they're both good and bad in their own ways. And I don't really find one to be better than the other. And Spider-Man 3 was kind of wonky for me. It was, you know, it just didn't really fit. The first two were pretty good. That really felt like a comic book movie. And The Amazing Spider-Man 2, I mean, it's newer. It looks flashier. And Andrew Garfield as Spider-Man is pretty good. He brings the, you know, the cocky, smart-ass Spider-Man to the screen. Tobey Maguire brought the nerdy side. So, I don't know. Get off my booty, man! Get out of here! I want to kill you. I mean, you're just like a mud crab, dude. Just mud crabbing it up. Mr. Krabs! Mr. Krabs! I have an idea! And my idea is to blow your ass up with some fireball action. Alright, maybe that won't work under the sea. Alright, I'm just rambling on here. A lot of wonky things going on. We are here at Glimreach, finally. Right? Yes. Go ahead and armor up here. So yeah, I guess another quick recap of the question of the day. If you could live in... I guess I'll open up the map while I talk about this. If you could live in any city or hold in Skyrim, where would it be? Okay, we got Solitude, we got Markarth. Still undiscovered. I've discovered the Keep of Markarth, but not Markarth the city. How does that happen? I don't know. We got Falkreath. This is the area where I chose. We got Whiterun. Which, by the way, the Whiterun hold extends so far, it's ridiculous. I remember having a quest a while ago from the Companions. This is another character a long time ago, where it had me go kill some vampires, and it was over here. Or maybe it was over here, even. I mean, sweet jeebus, it was far. I didn't realize. anyway, we got Riften here, a Windhelm here, Winterhold, and Dawnstar. So, where would you guys choose to live? Kind of curious. And which Spider-Man movies did you prefer? Kind of a strange mixture of questions, but just feel like tossing them at you. Little question tossing action. Question tossing action. Wait, I feel like this is just like an animals only cave. No human enemies. Trolls? Who's trolling? Come out and play. Because I ain't got all day. Ooh, juniper berries. Reminds me of Rayloff from the intro sequence. Used to be sweet on a girl from here. Used to make that mead with juniper berries mixed in or something like that. That's stupid. He says it every time. Are any of you guys sick of that intro sequence for Skyrim? Like how many- Oh no! Oh, for fuck's sake. Like every time you start a new character, you gotta go through that bullshit. Unless you use a previous save game for right before the character creation screen. But my god, I mean, after a while, that intro starts to wear on you. Oh, I gotta deal with these motherfuckers. God, I hate this place. Or I hate Fulmer. I hate Charis, and I heard a Charis in here. Come out. You know what? I got a little, frost rune for ya. Huh, and that did nothing. Hooray! It looked like he exploded into goop. I think that was his poison attack. Yeah, come over here. God, that explosion is so unnecessarily huge and loud. But there's no kill quite like overkill. Am I right, folks? Quick saving right about now. What is that? Oh, it's a dead goat. Oh, jeebus. Machine gun, icy spear, go! And miss every single one. Oh wait, that's way too much healing. Alright, screw aiming. Hey, dead goat, how you doing? Oh no, is that Dova Goat from like 30 episodes ago? No! Not Dova Goat. He had so many more dragons to ride. If you guys remember that wonky moment in that episode, if you guys were there to see it happen, feel free to leave a comment down below, hashtag DovaGoat. You know, Dova like Dova King, yeah, you know. Hello, random frostbite spider trapped in a jail cell. What's going on? I'll free you. We can be best bros. If I can get through this lockpick, alright. Oh, come on. Got it. Don't turn hostile. Oh, for fuck's sake. Look what happens when I try to be good guy Archmage. You know what? You can just sit in there. I tried to be nice, but no. So now you can... Excuse me, sir! Spider and I are trying to have a conversation. This is between A and B, so see your way out of it. And he shoots me through the bars like a jerk. Alright, that's the last time I help a spider in need. Alright, from here on out, it's death to all your kind. Oh, screw your moonstone ore. I don't need that. So, on my way back from the gym today, I guess this is the episode of Random Stories. I stopped by the drugstore, got a gallon of milk. Typical barbell action, because I go through a gallon of milk a day, for those of you who did not know. And I came out and I felt something on my head. So I swatted at my head. I looked down and I was like, oh Lord Jesus, it's a beetle. And it's this huge ass beetle. I mean, this beetle was so huge it gave me bronchitis. Ain't nobody got time for that. And I don't know, I just felt like telling you guys about this giant beetle that was on my head. And thankfully nothing happened aside from the bronchitis. I made it out okay, which is why I'm recording this episode. And speaking of the gym, I actually joined a new gym. In my, I guess, gym career, I only went to one. So for the past few years, I only went to one gym and I just got tired of the place. It just turned into some real bullshit. So I left there and I joined a new one and it's actually a 24-hour gym. Oh yeah. Now, that's what I'm talking about. I mean, 24 hours, I can go whenever I want and it's good. So there's some random stories for you today. I mean, there's not a lot going on. We just got regular Falmer. We got spiders trapped in jail cells. It's rather gloomy in here. Whoa! Jeebus! How dare you activate your own traps and scare the piss out of me. Come on, double spells. Double spells all the way across the sky. Let's go. Damn. Let's just wind up for anyone else who comes through. Do we have a volunteer? Oh, whoa. Okay, that didn't hurt as much as I thought. Still rude. Haha, I can shoot over this fence and you can't. I win, you lose. Good day, sir! Do I go down or up, down, or all around? Choices, choices. I'll just go this way. Clearly the wrong way. Instant dead end. That was put there just to troll me. Alright, time to be lazy.
Fire!
Lazy mode, initiate! Ugh! Here's someone. Alright, see someone on the radar. The radar? Oh my god! I can't speak tonight. Ugh. See, we got quite a few dudes in here. Ugh. Who else? Who wants to take a nap? A dirt nap, if you will. Whoa. Shadow Master, eh? Well, I need to armor up right now. Let's hide behind this pillar. Up. Oh, he's advancing. Let's stop his advancement. Stop right there, criminal scum! Alright. You may proceed to die now. Actually, let's re-paralyze. And let's just go apeshit on this guy. Hooray for cheap tactics! Did someone just come down here with me? Where'd he go? I can't see! I have too much power! It obstructed my own vision. Wait, did you fall down the fun hole? Oh my god, the fun hole. Oh no, that sounds so bad. Oh jeez. Welcome to Barbell's Let's Plays. We're all about maturity here. Oh no, the fun hole. God. Moving on. Back for more, eh? Lucky for you, I have more than you can handle. Goodbye. You are the weakest link. Alright, so apparently what we're looking for is in this here chest. Gold. Staff of the Familia. Wind and sand. Worth 100. Is it a skill book as well? Nothing. Alright. Well, whoopty friggin' do. We'll return this to Neeloth, hopefully learn the new spell. And it looks like that'll be just the right amount of time to end the episode. We've got the end of dungeon... Oh, jeebus. End of dungeon music going off. Another chest? Chest would be nice. I want more loots. Getting greedy up in here. More loot. Oh, and I'll also list off the question of the day winner from the last episode, which is what name should be given to the Dremora Merchant, which I also acquired in the last episode. I feel like there was a good amount of that cave I did not explore, and I'm completely okay with that because I hate Fulmer Dungeons. Hate. Like, all of my hate. I'm projecting all of my hate onto the Fulmer. Hello! Hey, dog! That was dog, everybody. Newest addition to the Skyrim character list. Hello! Hello there, Slaughterfish! That's Slaughterfish. That's the newest addition to the Skyrim character list. Oh, jeez. Hey, thanks for being somewhere other than up in my face for once. I do appreciate it. Sincerely. Alright, Neeloth, we're coming back with your stupid book. Oh, man. And it'd been all over the place for this episode. It's been good. Good stuff. Good stuff. Let's go ahead and float on up here. Sorry, I had to take a drink. Hopefully it didn't display on the mic, or I don't know, broadcast over the microphone. Hey.
Where is that lazy steward of mine? Verona? Oh, no, wait, she's dead. Drovers!
Alright, here's a book.
Perhaps this particular source was worth more than I thought he was. Pity. In any case, this is truly amazing. I think I can adapt this into a sort of whirlwind vortex energy.
Yes.
I'll write it out, and you can pick up a copy from Talbot's in a few days.
A few days? I ain't got
in
a few days!
Take this for helping me.
How about a few minutes? Wow, 250 gold. You shouldn't have. No, really, you shouldn't have. That's just an insultingly low amount.
Get back to work.
Well, shut up. What's your work? Just staring at this potion? Alright. Do you have the spell? Has it been a few days?
You wish to master the arcane arts.
Whirl. Holy shit, it's there! Ha ha! Alrighty. Spell tome all the way down here. Boom! Let's check it out. Destruction, I believe. Whirlwind. Why does it have a frost icon? Whatever. For 60 seconds, opponents in melee range have a chance of being flung away like yesterday's garbage. Get out of here! Taking out the trash. That's gonna be cool. Let's just activate it. So it looks just like any other cloak spell, except it's just air. And I guess we'll need to get close to an enemy and... Let's see, does it hurt him? Okay, I guess it's only active like when you're in combat or something. So that's gonna be pretty cool. I would use it now, but we're approaching the hour mark and I really don't want to start on another dungeon, but we'll see what it does in the next episode. Should be pretty cool. Obviously it just flings people away, but I just want to see it in action. Anywho, let's go ahead and bring up the comment shoutouts of the day. And here we go, the question of the day contest winner, it's going to be Apu. Multiple people said this, and I thought it was really clever to have Apu. If you guys don't know, that's the shopkeeper at the Quickie Mart from The Simpsons. Thank you, come again. You know, that guy. And I think that's going to be a good fit for our Dremora merchant buddy. I've got some honorable mentions here. Someone said, name him Darth Maul. He looks like the Sith from Star Wars. And yes, he does. And that was said by Alex here. He does look like the Darth Maul from Star Wars. And I thought I was really debating on going with that. But in the end, I went with Apu, mainly because a lot of people suggested it. And one other honorable mention, excuse me, is to name him Fuckers. Because when he goes, say you later, Fuckers! And that was made by Tachigami Let's Plays. I hope I said that correctly. I thought that was really creative. Name him Fuckers so you can say, see you later, Fuckers! That was pretty good. So thank you guys. Thanks to everyone who made a suggestion for his name. There are a lot of good ones. I didn't want to have a huge list of honorable mentions. But yeah, it's going to be named Apu. So let's go ahead and summon Apu right here. Black Market Power. Boom! So we meet again. And here it is. Here's Apu. I love it. I wish to buy. Oh, we got Apu here.
Let's make a deal.
That's so fitting. Oh, you guys are great. Seriously, you are all fantastic. Why do I have a candlestick? Get out of here. What? It was Archmage in the kitchen with the bowl? All right. Get that out. Dragonbone. I guess I could use those for dragon armor crafting, but I'm nowhere near the dragon equipment crafting perk and smithing. That requires 100, so I don't even know why I brought it up. Sigil stone, worth nothing, weighs nothing. Therefore, it's nothing.
Ah, sweet Oblivion, soon I shall return.
Okay, so apparently Apu is from Oblivion. The more you know, you'll never look at that guy the same from The Simpsons, knowing that he is actually a Dremora from the Oblivion realm. Kind of creepy when you think about it. But all right, guys, I'm going to go ahead and end the episode here. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you all enjoyed it. I'll see you on the next episode for some more Skyrim action. Take care, everybody. Bye.